Hey there, this is Anika Costa, BCBA and Executive Director with Brett DiNovi and Associates, and we're talking about the transition to telehealth. According to Barrett et al. 2006 and Ferguson et al. 2019, telehealth has been employed for almost two decades in the delivery of ABA assessment and treatment to individuals with ASD and training caregivers in the delivery of ABA services. Studies have also shown successful implementation of telehealth to effectively train staff. The Council for Autism Service Providers has outlined descriptions of the various ABA telehealth service delivery models in their manual titled Practice Parameters for Telehealth Implementation of Applied Behavior Analysis, Continuity of Care During COVID-19 Pandemic 2020. The service delivery models they review are the partial telehealth model, telehealth direct services and clinical direction model, caregiver implemented services model, and the caregiver consultation model. So let's break this down. In-person direct services and telehealth clinical direction is a hybrid model that involves partial telehealth, in which a technician delivers services in person with the learner and the behavior analyst, provides clinical oversight remotely via synchronous or asynchronous modalities. Many practitioners may have used this model to provide remote consultation or clinical supervision. This model could allow continuation of a learner's ABA program at the recommended dosage or continue with a slight reduction in the dosage. In light of COVID-19, however, this model may currently not be an option for service provision due to state and local guidelines on recommendations for essential service providers and social distancing. This model may be appropriate if the learner or other members of the household are immunocompromised or if the caregiver prefers to reduce contact with other individuals, like in the partial telehealth model. This model could allow the caregiver to continue to implement protocols on which they have been trained or to be coached by a technician to implement new or modified protocols with the learner. This model could allow the learner to receive a reduced level of services, perhaps focused on practicing or developing adaptive behaviors or maintaining daily routines in order to prevent regression, maintaining function, and or reduce occurrences of maladaptive or problem behaviors. The caregiver consultation model may be a good option for caregivers who are not able to deliver services directly to the learner, but may benefit from caregiver training and consultation with the behavior analyst on strategies to prevent regression by the learner and reduce the likelihood of crisis situations. Alternatively, or additionally, the behavior analyst might train caregivers to implement a small subset of protocols that are deemed high priority and within the caregiver skills and capacity. So this model could be used as part of a services package that may include a mix of caregiver implemented services and or direct telehealth. This model focuses on antecedent interventions, crisis prevention, problem solving individual concerns with the caregiver. For caregivers who are unable to participate in direct services and clinical direction, or caregiver implemented telehealth delivery service models, they still benefit from caregiver consultation, support, and general parent training provided by a behavior analyst. The focus of caregiver consultation and support is on problem solving daily routines, maladaptive behaviors, and providing feedback and reinforcement on strategies implemented in the home. Caregiver consultation is also an opportunity to evaluate any emerging concerns that may arise due to changes in the learner's routine, home structure, or family systems related to COVID-19. As telehealth is quickly evolving, especially under the current conditions, we encourage you as practitioners to continue to keep abreast of the ever-growing body of literature to inform your practice in telehealth to meet the needs of diverse learners and their caregivers. I'm Anika. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again soon.